Bristol Community College, Mathematics with Dan Avedikian, Math 119, Fundamental Statistics, Section 7.4, Problem 5. This is Section 7.4, Problem number 5. It says the heights of women are normally distributed with a mean of 65 inches and a standard deviation of 2.5 inches. Find the probability that a woman will be, and we have A, B, C, D, E, and the first one is taller than 72 inches tall. So that's 6 feet tall. What's the probability that a woman will be taller than 6 feet tall? So because the problem says normally distributed, what that means is I get to use the bell curve and the chart that goes with it. That's what normally distributed means. Now, the thing is, I cannot put in a 72-inch woman in the standard normal chart and get any type of answer for it. I have to find the z-score for a 72-inch tall woman. So the z-score formula is z equals x minus the mean divided by the standard deviation. And x is the number we want to find the z-score for this particular problem, 72. Then minus the mean or average value is given as 65 inches, divided by the standard deviation, also given 2.5. So now in the numerator, 72 minus 65, positive 7, and underneath 2.5. Now, if you're good with fractions, you could try and reduce that and come up with an answer. Most people just want to use their calculator. 7 divided by 2.5 equals, and you'll get 2.8. So 2.8 is the z-score. That's what we can look up in the chart. So to look up 2.8 in the chart, step one, write it so that it has two places after the decimal. So the way you get it out of your calculator, it will only have one place after the decimal. So we'll start by writing it as 2.80. Now it has two places after the decimal. The next step is split the number into two parts by pulling off the rightmost digit, the zero that we just put in. So it'll be 2.8 and 0. So now the next step is put a .0 in front of that rightmost digit that you pulled off. And now go to the positive 2.8 row of the chart, the 0, 0 column, and see where they intersect. And they will intersect at .9974. Now that's not the answer yet. Is there a 99% probability that a woman will be taller than 6 feet tall? That'd mean almost all women are taller than 6 feet tall, and as you see women around you every day, you'd know that's not the case. So this is taller than, it's like a greater than. So if the average height is 65, 72 is bigger, we want to find the area past the 72. So what the chart gives us, the 9974, is the blank portion of the bell curve. So we have to do 1 minus that. So 1 minus 0.9974 will be 0.0026. So the probability that a woman is taller than 6 feet tall is 0.0026. It's about 0.25%. It's very unlikely. So that's A. B, what's the probability that a woman is shorter than 68 inches? So it's the same type of process. You have to find the z-score for 68 inches. You can't put a 68-inch woman into the row and column and find an answer. So let me make a little bit of room. I'll leave my z-score formula because I'm going to need it. But now the value of x, it was 72 for part A. For part B, it's 68. That's the number we want to find the z-score for. The rest of it is the same. I actually could have left the rest. The mean, it was 65. It's still 65. The mean is 65. And in the denominator, the standard deviation, still 2.5. So now on the top, 68 minus 65 is positive 3. And you have 3 over 2.5. And that should come out to 1.2 if you divide it. 3 divide by 2.5 equals, I think it's 1.2. I'm trying to use the math tricks. Let's check that with the calculator. And it is. So now, we want to look up 1.2 in the standard normal chart. So we have to write it so that it has two places after the decimal, so that 1.2 can be written as 1.20. Then next after that, you split the number into two parts by pulling off the rightmost digit, so it'll split as 1.2 and 0. The step after that is you put a 0.0 in front of the rightmost digit that you pulled off. So instead of just plain old 0, it's 0.00 now. And now what you do is you go to the 1.2 row of the chart. Again, this is a positive 1.2 row. The 0.00 column, which will be the first or leftmost column, and they will intersect at 0.8849. That's the answer from the chart. Now, this question says shorter than. So shorter than is like less than. The chart tells you less than. So again, visually what's going on, use the bell curve because it's a normally distributed problem. The average value is 65, that goes in the middle. They want to know if it's 68, it's a little bigger, so I'll write it to the right of the 65 or after it. The probability of being shorter would be the probability that's to the left. And that 8849 that we're getting from the chart is exactly the area that we're looking for. So the probability that a woman is shorter than 68 inches is 0.8849, or approximately an 88.5% probability. So the next problem, taller than 62 inches. So same process. We're going to use the z-score formula, find the z-score for 62 inches, look it up in the chart. The taller than, though, we're going to wind up doing the 1 minus. So again, let me leave the z-score formula, and I'll be a little bit smarter this time and save myself some work. And I can leave most of the formula. Oops, I erased the wrong part. The x is what changed. So now x, the number we want the z-score for, is 62. It was 68 for the previous part. So now x goes in as a 62. I meant to keep the mean and erase the other one, but that's okay. The mean right there it is, 65 inches. Standard deviation on the bottom. Again, standard deviation is still 2.5. So now, when I subtract on top 62 minus 65, that's 3 again. Right now, here's where you want to be careful. It's negative 3. Don't lose the negative. 62 minus 65 is negative 3. 2.5 on the bottom. So, negative 3 divided by 2.5. It was 1.2 before for the previous part. I know this time it's going to be negative 1.2. So very similar. Now negative 1.2 is what I want to look up. First, I want to write it so that it has two places after the decimal. So I have to fill in a 0 to get my two places after the decimal. I'm going to split that into two parts by pulling off the rightmost digit. So I'll have negative 1.2 from the left. The 0 on the right comes off to the side. The step after that is you put a 0.0 in front of the rightmost digit that you took off. So instead of 0, it's 0.00. Now, you're going to a completely different part of the chart. When you look up negative 1.2 now, that's a different row than positive 1.2. You see where the negative 1.2 row intersects with the 0.00 column, and it's going to be 0.1151. Very different answer. Now, the thing is, this question says taller than. So again, to get the visual, 65 is right in the middle because it's the average, what they tell us the average is. 62 is less, so it's going to be a little before or to the left of. And the question asks for the probability of being taller than 62. Now, the 0.1151 from that standard normal chart is the blank area that I'm not interested in. I want the shaded area on the right of the 62. So, easy enough, 1 minus what I got from the chart, 1151. And when you do the subtraction, it does coincidentally come out to the same answer as the previous part. It's also 0.8849. It's an 88.5% probability within reasonable round off. So, part D, what's the probability that a woman would be shorter than 60 inches. So that's shorter than 5 feet tall. So it's starting to get to be pretty short. What's the probability of being even shorter than 5 feet tall? So it's starting to become a little bit unlikely. So let me again make a little room. I can leave my z-score formula. And this time I'll erase the correct part. So to find the probability for 60, I need to convert 60 and find the z-score for 60. So this time I erased the right part. The value of x now, the number I want the z-score for, now it's 60. Minus is still there. The mean is still 65. The standard deviation is still 2.5. All that stays the same. So when I do the subtraction now, 60 minus 65, that will be a negative 5 on the top. Pay attention to the sign. 2.5 underneath. This one I can do pretty comfortably without a calculator. Minus 5 divided by 2.5. The 2.5 goes in twice. Just don't lose the negative. It's negative 2. And again, if you're not comfortable with that, by all means, do it on the calculator. It takes a couple of seconds. So negative 2 is what we want to look up in the standard normal chart. So first, write the number to look up so that it has two places after the decimal. So that negative 2 has to be written as negative 2.00. Now I have two places after the decimal. Next, split the number into two parts by pulling off the rightmost digit. So the rightmost 0 is going to come off. So I'm going to have negative 2.0 from the left side and just a 0 on the right. After I do that, put a point